Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Just Say Sports. My name is Rob Galtere. It's been a while since we've been on. We apologize, but we're back. With me again, Chris Barto. Chris?
Great to see you, Rob.
Great to see you.
A lot to talk about.
Last time we were here, Joe Girardi was leading the troops through... Leading the troops.
You know, the state of the Phillies at that point, that this has stuck with me since it happened. I turned the radio on the car, and they were discussing Jalen Reagor's flaws as a punt returner.
that pretty much summed it up. I mean, they were that bad to watch.
Oh, just awful in every way. Yeah.
And for a guy who really doesn't have a history of firing managers, and it was Dombrowski who brought him in. It took a lot of guts. I'll give him that.
It did, and it took a lot to get him to that point. But obviously, I think he had been there for a little bit and gave him every possible chance to turn it around, and it just didn't happen.
Yeah, it didn't matter what move Girardi made. It was the wrong move. I mean, he just – talk about a guy who really didn't have a pulse for the team, didn't have the, and then you find out later, and of course this always happens after a team has success, after a manager leaves, but you know, there were a lot of problems in the clubhouse. He was not a player friendly manager. He kept to himself.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently there is that different atmosphere with Philly Rob Thomas,
right?
At the helm. So 15-3, 14-3 since the firing, 15-3 overall the last 18. I put this to you though. The team is 15-3 in their last 18. Do you think they've even come close to reaching their potential?
They're getting there, but I would say no, because a lot of the guys still have not hit.
Not at all. I'm looking at this and JT Realmuto is a replacement level player right now, and you got to think he's going to get somewhat better.
I'm glad you brought him up, because without question in my mind, he is the one guy in that lineup that has zero plan every time he steps into the batter's box.
He is so lost. And a lot of it, you know, there were some changes that the hitting coach wanted to make, and something about lifting his left foot, or he liked to lift it. They wanted to keep it down, and then he tried to go back to that, and then at it, and then nothing's working. I've never seen a guy hit more. There are no line drives. It's either the soft ground ball or the pop up.
Yeah, that big hit he had was complete luck.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he has no plan and little shot to do any damage.
Yeah.
It's dumbfounding to me. He's gone backwards ever since he signed the big contract.
Well, and the thing with that big hit, if the infield's back, it's double play.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just he's been terrible. And he's been terrible. It's affecting his defense, too. I mean, we've seen that a few times.
Yeah, the drop pop foul was terrible.
The Suarez game when he was going to get out of the inning in the first inning with nothing. Double play ball right back at him. He throws it to home and he drops the ball. And they're like, well, he threw it.
So what? You're an all-star, supposedly. You can reach it, you catch it.
I'd say you give me 100 college catchers, and I'm not even talking Division I, Division III. I'd say 99% of high school catchers make that play.
Agree.
It was a routine play.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't had to catch it hardball for I don't know how many years, and I think I'm pretty confident I make that play.
Yeah. Yeah. He's been an utter disappointment, and I don't know what you do other than give Stubbs more time. He's earned it.
Or let's move him back in the lineup.
Oh, yeah, for sure. He shouldn't be in the middle.
You've got the contingent. I don't know what you call that 1-2-3. especially this June until Harper got hurt. But I mean, Schwarber, Hoskins, and Harper were the leading OPS guys in the month of June for the entire National League. Mm-hmm. And yet there you're 1-2-3. And then you follow it up with a guy who's struggling still, Castellanos, which he's been a little bit, I mean, that's another guy, you know, if I'm going to go down the list of not reaching their potential, he isn't even coming close right now.
I hit 320 last year, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
And he doesn't look like he's in a huge funk. He's just not putting consistent at-bats together every game.
Yeah, it looks like he's not picking up the guys are getting ahead of him just with those low and away sliders, bang, 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 constantly. And I'm more confident that he's going to turn it around because he is showing some line drives, a little pop. Mm-hmm. Real Muto's not doing any of that.
No, Castellanos is almost looking like when Hoskins struggles, he's falling down. Mm-hmm. When he's swinging, he's off balance. And that's what Hoskins has not done. He's dug in and obviously seeing the ball well and connecting well, which is great to see, and can only hope he keeps it up.
So let's go through the lineup. How many of the Phillies are playing to their potential? We're playing like we need you to play at least, not your best, but when you're good. I'd say Harper.
For sure.
Hoskins.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
I thought Segura was.
Yes. Bohm's approaching where he should be.
250 hitter with no pop.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, he's throwing in some clutch hits. I wrote him down. Schwarber. He's hitting 220, but now he's getting a lot of walks. His OPS is climbing. I think this is what we expected of Schwarber.
Yes. His run production is extremely high, which is what you need from your leadoff batter.
So there's a lot, I think there's a lot of room for improvement. I don't think, now you go through the starting rotation, I don't think Suarez is anywhere near where he should be.
No. And he's still 5-4 somehow.
Yeah. Eflin, I don't think we can count on him the rest of the year.
You wonder if he's injured again. Supposedly he came out of that 80-pitch outing where he was dominating because of knee soreness.
Mm-hmm.
So, obviously, you need your legs if you're a pitcher.
And this is what happened to him last year, and he never got it back.
Mm-hmm.
And now, really, the only option they have in the minor leagues is Bailey Falter, who's not bad.
A fifth or sixth starter, right?
Yeah. Right. But that really pushes, you know, suddenly Kyle Gibson and Ranger Suarez are your 3 and 4.
Mm-hmm.
When Eflin looked like a pretty steady 3 behind two very dominant pitchers right now in Wheeler and Nola. That's what was giving me hope, that this team hadn't hit yet and you had two number ones the way they're pitching right now, Wheeler and Nola.
Yeah. Wheeler, 8 earned runs in his last 8 outings, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And Nola's probably not doing much worse than that.
No.
It's great to see, and they're doing that despite Real Muto being anything but great behind the plate.
Yeah.
So that should give you hope and no reason why that can't continue.
Then it comes to the bane of our existence, the bullpen. The thing that makes us come back every 2 weeks to just say sports is to talk about the Phillies bullpen.
Oh, yes.
How difficult is it?
I tell you, if you ran the stats, at least 80% of the time, the first pitch by every relief pitcher is a ball, let alone the first two.
Outside of Dominguez.
Right, yeah. Sir Anthony's the exception probably to everything. And Brad Hand overall has been acceptable.
He's been acceptable.
Yeah.
But he's now put in a position that he's proving he no longer can handle. You cannot have a closer as a left-hander who doesn't throw higher than mid or low 90s, mm-hmm. and who uses just one. Like, it's not like it's a splitter or it's a slider.
He's a left-handed Larry Anderson.
Yeah.
one-dimensional, and eventually you're going to get hit.
Right. He should be in for the seventh inning. That's a problem right now. They've got a lot of seven-inning guys. Dominguez, I think, can handle the closer spot. I've got no issues at all. But you've just taken him out of those pressure seventh and eighth, where you, the heart of the lineup. Like the game, everyone was having a fit that Brad Hand came in to close the other night when Dominguez pitched the eighth and then Hand pitched the ninth. Mm-hmm. Well, Dominguez faced the heart of the order. He faced their 3, 4, 5,
yes,
which was great managing, mm-hmm, something Girardi would have never done in a billion years.
Right.
He would have had Dominguez pitching in the fifth or sixth, probably. Mm-hmm. But that was a great move. But, okay, you've got to have another Dominguez. You've got to have a setup guy to get to Dominguez.
You have to hope that Brogdon continues pitching well,
mm-hmm,
and can develop into that spot.
And I think Brogdon could be your seventh inning guy.
Agree, yeah.
Leaves me an inning still. Leaves me that eighth inning. Is Knebel have any chance at all to be that eighth inning guy?
I would say slim to none.
He looks lost. I think he's hurt.
Yeah, his windup, whatever, is so terrible. It looks like he has every ounce in his body to throw as hard as he can, mm-hmm, and he has no control.
Well, they pull him the one day, say he's not available because of his shoulder. Then his next two outings, when Real Muto's outside and high with the glove, and every pitch is going inside and low, there's something grabbing that shoulder. You know, we've both thrown softballs, hardballs, whatever. When you get a click in there, it's not letting you go to the direction you want to go.
He threw a ball four, like, chin high his last outing, I think.
Yeah.
It wasn't even close.
Yeah, so, and I think there's an issue there. I can't count on him the rest of the year. I'm okay with Hand. I'm okay with Brogdon. Those are my sixth, seventh inning guys. You got to have an eighth inning guy or a closer.
Yeah, and we know closers just don't grow on trees.
No, unless you pay for them. Which leads to the question, you've got what I guess people would consider three untouchables, Mick Abel, Andrew Painter, and Rojas in the minor leagues. Is there anyone else out there in the minor leagues that you wouldn't part with for this team? Keeping in mind that the Atlanta Braves made moves, won a World Series as a barely above 500 team heading down the stretch. The Nationals won a World Series as a barely 500 team heading down to the second half of the season.
Our Reading Phillies catcher, I would not part ways with.
Yeah, especially with the way Real Muto's playing.
He has serious potential.
He does.
All around. Yeah. Got to see him Saturday night in person. He didn't have a great hitting night, but there was a play at home. Throw comes from the outfield late. Runner scores. He didn't bother trying to tag. He just fired to second. An absolute bullet and tugged the guy out to end the inning then. Yeah. I've gotten great reports on him every night from somebody that works there. So, yeah. Other than that, I think that's the end of the story for prospects.
Which probably doesn't leave you with the ability to get. It's the head scratching, the $6 million for Familia.
Is he terrible? Oh.
Oh, the Mets fans couldn't believe it.
I saw him in person two Saturdays ago, and by dumb luck somehow he got out of an inning without giving up a run, and it was just hold your breath pretty much every pitch.
Oh, it's not like they don't throw money at the problem. It's just maybe they don't go for the big score. They're always trying to.
They've gotten names, but after their prime.
Right.
Which only goes so far.
Right.
You're hoping they can rekindle that flame, and it normally doesn't happen.
Speaking of closers, the most unhittable closer in baseball, Josh Hader. What in the heck happened that game? The odds of...
Yeah, seriously.
Boehm, who hasn't hit a ball, I think he's hit one ball over an outfielder in the last, since that game.
Mm-hmm.
And Matt Beerling, who's, we've seen occasionally, gets a hold of one. I mean, the guy has been untouchable for...
A year. Yeah. Yeah, that was amazing to come out of that game with a win.
It's just the way that... And when I say that they aren't playing to their potential, they could start playing to their potential and obviously not go on a 15-3 run.
Mm-hmm.
Because are you going to really be able to replay the Bryson Stott home run, the Garrett Stubbs home run, the Veerling home run?
The Harper Slam.
The Harper Slam. The Jairo Munoz go-ahead home run in the eighth.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're absolutely right. You need everything to go right. And you need teams like the Nationals to fall into your schedule who's doing everything wrong like you were before the managerial change.
Mm-hmm.
I said before that series they needed to win 4 out of 5, and they did. 5 would have been great, but they got the 4 that they had to get.
Yeah.
Now, I looked at the pitchers for this Rangers series. It's going to be interesting.
Yeah.
Because John Gray at 2-3 is the worst starter they're going to face. The other two starters have winning records. So you absolutely can't get swept, and at a minimum, you got to win one.
Mm-hmm. No, you can't get you no. You just have to keep winning.
Yeah.
But if Harper can't play, this team has shown it. The most ridiculous thing ever. You're going for a sweep, a 4-game sweep against the Dodgers in LA. Let's take the most scalding hot hitter I've seen in the last decade. Let's give him a shot now.
Yeah. I didn't understand it at the time, and in hindsight, it looks even more stupid.
And then the team went...
Yeah.
And now we've seen with the blister, and please explain to me how a major league hitter, is he, because he's at the DH, he's just sitting in the cage and swinging and swinging and swinging and swinging and swinging to the point that...
He must be. But he is the guy for sure that has a plan every time he steps into the batter's
right
box.
Right now, he's so zoned in.
His mentality is, you're not getting me out.
Right.
And at a minimum, I'm putting the ball in play.
I think you continue to surround him with the thought of, you don't have many opportunities to have a Bryce Harper at his peak. The Angels blew it.
Mm-hmm.
With Trout.
Yep.
That's why I think if a Rojas or Ohapi or McAbel or Painter or someone, it gets you the help you need.
Yeah. You also have some of these big time signings for another 3 or 4 years too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know.
So that's why Dombrowski gets paid to be that GM president.
Yeah. Well, let's just say this. Thank goodness for the DH rule, because they didn't have Harper, this team's the Nationals.
Isn't it nice that Matt Veerling turned into the Phillies' Chris Taylor in the course of a week?
Yeah.
And just doing it well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think there was so much pressure on him at the beginning of the year. I think pressure he put on himself.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, dude, you're batting 9th.
Yeah.
We just want you to make the plays in center field. We want to avoid having to use Odubel Herrera, who still gets at-bats over and over. And the more at-bats he gets, you just watch his OPS sink like a rock.
Yeah, I checked before the show. He's down to .240 batting average.
Yeah. Yeah, he was like at an 830, 840 OPS when he was a part-time player. And then suddenly they're throwing him out there every day. Now he's like a 750 already.
I looked right after our last show at Realmuto's OPS, and I think it was about 614. and I should have checked again, but my guess is it's probably similar.
I'd say it's about 614. Yeah,
which is pathetic.
It's terrible. He does it doesn't draw walks. When does he even hit a hard foul ball?
He's so, like the word you use, lost, is perfect, because he does not look like a major league hitter whatsoever.
No, and that's what gives me hope, because he is a major league hitter. We've seen it. He's not over the hill. It's not like he's on the downside of his career. This should be the peak of his career.
Yeah, well, he needs to get straightened out soon.
Yeah, he does need to get straightened out. Since we've been gone, the Sixers lost in the second round again and again in the playoffs. Not once, but twice, Joel Embiid. He makes it through basically an entire season, and then as soon as the playoffs hit, obviously no fault of his own. Severe injuries that, I mean, when you have a torn up thumb and a broken face, there was no anybody who had an expectation for them to win that series was crazy.
Yeah.
And suddenly everyone's upset at Harden. What's Harden going to do?
Yeah, he had a few moments, which is pretty much where you're at with him at this point, I think.
Right. He's a compliment.
Yeah.
He's a compliment to the best player in the NBA when he doesn't have a broken face and torn thumb.
And Tobias Harris gave a really good effort overall.
It's the best Tobias has played as a Sixer.
Yeah. He was determined defensively.
But you put him, you put, you know, Maxey next year, you have Harden with that set role, and a healthy Joel Embiid, they get past the second round. There's no doubt in my mind.
Agree, yeah.
But, I mean, when you take away Embiid's ability to hit a three-pointer, which the thumb did.
Oh, for sure.
The ability to dominate the offensive boards, because basically he's just going to get punched around in the face because guys are just going to swing their arms.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, it was rough. Rough ending to the season. Certainly had higher hopes for where they could have gone, but once again denied.
Once again. You know, today's the anniversary. The anniversary of Ben Simmons. The no look.
Dunk
to pass. Matisse Thybulle. The pass that changed the course of the Sixers.
Yes. Wow, that was only a year ago.
Thybulle was only double covered. That was okay.
Yeah.
He caught it, made a free throw.
Right.
That was good stuff. Hey, big fan of the Live Tour. I don't know about you.
It's interesting. Tell me about it. I know there's a ton of controversy. And I guess what, Phil Mickelson got $200 million or something?
I think he did. Dustin Johnson got $125. Patrick Reed got money. Yeah. Basically, it's the tour for guys who are not old enough to be seniors, mm-hmm. but no longer can win against
the young studs.
These guys. So they're just cashing in and think people are going to watch it and care. Does anyone really care about Bryson DeChambeau? He had his few seconds of fame.
I don't believe so.
Patrick Reed's probably the most hated player on the tour.
Mm-hmm.
Fans can't stand him.
Yeah.
Mickelson's just a lightning rod. He's got some type of base, but most people are like, eh. And DJ's probably the dullest player.
Yeah, he is not charismatic at all.
So it leaves us with Graham McDowell. I don't get the billions. I think it's close to $1 billion by now of the money that they're throwing around.
Wow.
There's no cuts. You guarantee a paycheck.
Interesting.
So they just gave up the PGA Tour.
What that makes you think what Mickelson did when in the PGA last year at age 50 is phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
When you see these young guys dominating a major every time they come around. Just mind-boggling.
I mean, Scheffler and Zalatoris and Morikawa.
And now Fitzpatrick.
Fitzpatrick, who's been playing well in all the majors.
Yeah.
The list goes on. And
Jordan Spieth's almost old at this point.
Spieth, Schauffele, you know, if JT didn't rally to win that last one, I'd put him in the same company where these guys are already being pushed aside. And because you know behind these other guys, Scheffler, Zalatoris, and so forth, there's going to be another wave.
And the South American that blew it at the PGA. Who knows if he still plays well.
Mito Pereira?
Yeah, I believe that's right.
I don't quite.
So controversy in golf,
It is, it is. Probably don't have time to talk about it, but I don't know if you realize, but the Eagles are now the favorite to win the Super Bowl in the last since we last met. Haven't you read that everywhere?
I have not.
Howie's now a genius again. I can't keep up. Howie's a genius again.
Mike Trout called him a genius during the game when he was on the mic. Well, how about that?
Mike's a little blinded.
Yeah, a little bit.
A little blinded, but they did pick up A.J. Brown, which I thought was a great move on draft night to get a 25-year-old wide receiver.
Oh,
And lock him in for the 18th pick in the draft is I do give Howie kudos to that. Mm-hmm. I think it makes Devontae Smith better. And now, between those two and Dallas Goedert, you know where Hurts is. If Hurts can't be successful with that crew, Hurts is not going to be successful.
Yeah, and they stack some draft capital for next year.
And they did. So Howie did do a good job. Yeah. A lot of one-year signings. Mm-hmm. You know, everyone's all excited about Bradberry at the one corner. I mean, the guy just got toasted right and left on the Giants last year, so I'm not real confident about that. But otherwise, it also puts the heat, I think, on their linebacking core as well, on the defense as a whole, because everything was we'll give up six, we give up seven, all the way down the field. Now you've got guys who can potentially, you can't play that passive defense anymore.
And you no longer have rookie coaches and coordinators.
No.
So,
I'm looking forward to football. And you're looking forward to Carson Wentz, I bet.
How about Sam Howell, that first pick in the fifth round? That's a steal.
I saw some things still a couple weeks before the draft where they had him mid first round, like some people.
Yeah. Hey, let's.
Hey, you light up the Temple Owls. People remember that for years.
No doubt.
Another quarterback lit him up, Dan Brown. Hate to tell you that.
Okay.
That was in a bowl game for Duke. Temple got lit up a lot in the bowl games.
Yeah. Well, it's Carson's last shot, obviously, as a starter. If he fails, then he's a career backup. So
no, he could always come back. And the NBA draft is this Thursday. If you have number one, Chet Holmgren, Jabari Smith, Paolo Banchero.
Oh, boy.
I mean, is Holmgren anything more than jump shooting Sean Bradley?
That's the name I was just thinking. You would hope so. But time will tell there. I guess either Smith or
Banchero.
Yeah.
I mean, he was really good in the tournament. I was impressed with him.
He's got an NBA body already.
He does. He does. He can hit the jumper. Jabari Smith, when he's on, boy, he can dominate.
Yeah.
And where are you going to find? I used to call Holmgren the unicorn.
Mm-hmm.
Watch Jaden Ivey end up being the best of the bunch, or Keegan Murray.
Right. Yeah.
You know, there's some talent. None at 23. I think the Sixers trade out. I'm not even looking down at 23. I'm not even going down to those names because I don't think the Sixers are going to be around for that.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we touched on everything. Maybe next week we're going to do this again.
For sure.
And maybe the Yankees will lose a game by then.
Yeah. Wow.
Or they have to go about 500 the rest of the year to win 100 games.
Just about, I think. Yeah, it's incredible. Yeah.
Be fun to play him in the World Series with the eighth inning.
Mm-hmm.
Well, time flew by already. Half hour gone. So I appreciate you coming in.
A lot of fun.
Mm-hmm. For Chris Barto, I'm Rob Galtier. We'll see you next week on Just Say Sports.